Up next, we have Emily Bowlus-Peck, who is going to come from us from our History Department of College's Art and Sciences. Emily's going to talk about proto-psychiatry and lunatic hospitals, diagnostic madness in 18th century London. Very exciting title. Some fun facts, big video gamer, big fantasy novel, and likes dogs. What else can you want? If you are ready, set, pitch.
The pandemic has changed how we interact with our world, and it's impacted mental health. A quick show of hands, who here struggled or knows somebody that really struggled with how the pandemic first changed daily life? A lot of us, most of us. I think it's easier to talk about this a lot of times because we know that our entire community has undergone a similar struggle. And as a response, we've seen a rise in online mental health communities. Virtual therapy increased 63-fold from 2019 to 2020. So as a medical historian, it got me thinking, is the pandemic an anomaly? Or is there actually a history where mental health care developments have been influenced by communities in crisis? So my research wanted to look at the origins of our systems of psychiatric care. And to do this, I needed to go all the way back to 18th century England, really the foundation of American colonial medicine. And I stumbled upon something that really piqued my curiosity. Centuries ago, London had one asylum called Bedlam, and records revealed that they kept rejecting applicants they would diagnose as incurable, because incurables required indefinite care, and they had little hope of recovery. This diagnosis became a death sentence, and their displacement became inescapable. With nowhere to go, incurables were homeless, destitute, and many died on the city's overcrowded streets. And like the pandemic, the entire community struggled with these consequences. But interestingly, London philanthropists also noticed the community struggle, and they began asking Londoners what they felt the community and the city needed. And soon in the 1700s, new independent hospitals emerged throughout London, ones that will admit the incurable. And public support is so strong, these hospitals cannot keep up with the number of applicants that they receive. Now, it might not seem like it, but this research actually pertains to all of us. Because whether we're talking about 18th century hospitals, or we're talking about current pandemic responses, we're seeing that mental health care developments were and largely remain community-driven, and that this is most evident when a community undergoes a collective trauma, because it pushes those with power, wealth, and influence to produce necessary changes that end up being long-term because they're backed by public support. I find this incredibly inspirational because it shows that we as a collective have more influence over our medical landscapes than we've often been led to believe. Thank you.